That's Wally Bunting. What else is Tyson?
Is that why we're moving so fast?
It's Wally Bunting again.
That was Kaiser. It was Kaiser.
Yeah, Kaiser, right.
That was Cy Ocky right there.
Cy played softball?
Whoever it was, Cy. Maybe it was.
Kaiser's running again?
That was Alan Singel, I think.
No, that was Lenny Kaplan.
There's Rose. Coaching third.
Cy Ocky.
Cy Ocky, right.
Fuck, should be here.
Bastard should be here. That's Bert.
Who got hurt?
Hawaiian. Yeah. That was Camp. What is this? Another movie? Who's that?
Bill Day.
Judy Shapiro, right?
Right.
And Joanne Moff.
Joanne Moff.
Judy Shapiro. I know. I went with her after you did. There's me. I can tell by the haircut. There's Wallen. There's Ornstein.
What happened to Dave?
That's Fuzzy. I saw Fuzzy.
He's here. He's around. He's alive. Yeah. There's me again. That was a Braisley.
That's so
Barney
great.
Greenberg.
Barney Greenberg.
Remember that
thing we won? We got it up. Look at this.
This is
we were terrific. Yeah,
I like it.
That's
the Hawaiian
weekend.
The greatest party of all. I can't tell.
Hey,
who's
saw
that?
Saw the
that
was
Lynn's.
Show
it! Show it!
Putting this on. We're all enjoying the hell out of it. Wonderful. But thank them for what they did.
Yes, indeed.
He's wearing red. He's on. Get in. Come on. Lydia, you hire him at your place to work.
Uh-oh, I hear zippers opening.
Pick your leg. Show him
it.
Look at his sweats.
Go socks.
Is that on audio, too? Jerry's on scholarship, so he only has his shorts on.
Does it pick up sound?
No.
Yes?
You're all finished.
Sir.
What happened to his plate?
You got the muffler.
Oh my God! All right.
I always make sure.
Lenny, say something.
One more.
Get back over here.
Okay, ready? Here we go, ready?
Yes, somebody's grabbing my putts.
Thank you, sir.
Larry, yes, yes. Pledge class.
Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Yeah.
Larry, hold it in.
Oh, what?
We want it right now.
Oh, Pete, get over here, Peter.
Pete, get over here.
We're trying to get together. Who wants to be with for Olsen?
I don't know. Here we go, guys. Here we go. Guys.
One more, stay there.
Okay,
hang on. Pick your number one.
All right.
There we go.
Where's door number two?
One more.
Stay there.
Okay, here we go. Right here, guys.
Ready,
thank
stay
you.
There. Stay there.
Let's do it again.
Joe, wait. Hang on, don't move.
We broke even today.
Did it take it?
Yeah.
Okay.
They ruined my student. Can you hear me?
We drove down.
He charges $25.
On a mobile phone.
Fix my cup. Fix
it. Okay, fix up, kid.
All right,
fix
it. Let's go for the picture.
Videos are going to be
glasses. You didn't have glasses then.
Okay, let's go. Wait.
Okay.
One more, stay there.
Take the glasses off.
Okay, here we go, guys.
Show us, take those glasses.
Right over here. Okay, guys.
Show us to them.
Stay there.
Lenny, this is your pledge class.
This is it.
No, Schneider and I.
I thought your pledge were gross.
Okay, here we go, guys. Right here, guys.
One more, stay there.
Two more.
One more.
Let's take a look.
One more.
That's right, you got that. No, yours too, Wally. You got flagging shoes, but stop it.
Okay, here we go, guys.
Hey, no, you shell.
Right here, guys. Okay, one more.
One more.
Guys.
Go,
right there. Very good. One more, stay there. Okay, very good. Give me that smile. Here we go.
He's going to give you your microphone.
Hey, everybody got it.
Where's my time glass?
Get a wine glass.
Okay, ready? Here we go, guys.
Get your glass, please.
I'm going to take two pictures.
Okay. Stop. Where's the wives? You know what I want to say?
You're out of order.
Robert's rules of order.
Look at over this group. I want the rug and all.
Same way, too.
Who's laughing?
I never see a still camera go
hey,
stop it.
Jesus
Christ.
Hey, you two.
Peter, I think you're laughing. My daddy stole Pete. Hey, these knees ain't lasting.
I hold his staff.
Jim, tell us. Hold on, guys.
This could be the epic pictures, guys.
Come on.
One more.
Here we go.
Two more.
Guys, I just want to say what a wonderful time I'm having with my brothers. They'll always be my brothers. The time goes by, but we have that feeling that we're always together. We had a wonderful time together. And nothing will substitute for this time we're having tonight, really. And we love each other, and we always will. And Atlanta in 96.
Thank you, Bob Cohn, for the wonderful invitation for 96. It's good to see all my brothers here and some of the ones that I never met before, that I only heard about, and this is the greatest. Too bad guys had to miss this, but this is the best.
That's right.
Same thing.
Stay Bob Cohn. Stay Bob Cohn.
Thanks. Thanks to Bob Cohn for Atlanta. Hey, I got an extra bedroom or two. You know, it's close. Birmingham's close. But, we've spent hours reminiscing about all the good times. It's also a thrill to meet the guys that I never knew but heard about. And also we can reflect on this fabulous reunion in our future.
Yeah.
I want to recognize Bob Cohn's fabulous offer. More important, I want to recognize the efforts that Jerry has put into making this possible. I'm having a wonderful time. I'm looking forward to repeating it in Atlanta in 96, I guess it is. And I've watched Jerry go through the year trying to find everybody in the entire country. It was a tremendous effort, and we're all able to benefit from it. And thanks again, Jerry.
I'd just like to thank Bob for inviting us all to Atlanta, and Jerry telling us all to come to his house tomorrow. I just wanted to thank Jerry and Alan Morris. I think what they did was really great. The best time I've ever had. This is what memories are made of.
Tonight, ages have disappeared. You know, people from different classes, from all different years, have all mixed together. We've all heard each other's names. It's just been an absolutely wonderful weekend for everybody. Those who missed it, we still thought about them. And this tape is going to be buried, and it'll be opened again in Atlanta in 1996.
Yeah! And Bob Cohn's.
This has been a tremendous pleasure for me to be here. I'm only sorry that our brother Donald Trump couldn't be here with us to join in the celebration. But I was so happy Marlon Maples was going to be here to provide the entertainment. But I am so happy to have met all these old guys that I heard about when I came to the fraternity. And it's really amazing. You're all still alive. Geist is still here. And it's wonderful to see they're so young and so still full of life. And I really am looking forward to Atlanta in 96. It should be great. And I'm looking forward to the great hotel rooms we're going to have and the great tickets to the basketball game. So, Bob, you're a hell of a guy. It's great to be your fraternity brother.
I first want to thank Bob Cohn for his invitation in 93. I want to really thank Jerry and Alan for all they did. Probably if it wasn't for Jerry, I probably wouldn't be here with his pestering me. It takes a little pestering to get here. This was the greatest weekend. I said it before, and it's great seeing all the guys and a lot of guys that I had never met before. It was a pleasure.
How about the blonde you want to go out with? Put it in there. Okay, thank you.
Brother Kaiser, Brother Kaplan, all the brothers, it's an honor to be here from the University of Alabama. I welcome all the fraternity brothers of mine, and I hope to see everybody again real soon in Atlanta.
Well, Jerry, that's a mighty fine thing you said there. I want to remind you I sent you the cigarettes in North Carolina. What are you laughing at, schmuck? because you're going to be at Ever-Ready Candy for another 20 years.
I hope. Hey. Brother Taylor's father-in-law.
I only want to know one thing. I came down. I expected to see Jerry Geist. Instead of seeing Jerry Geist, I met Groucho Marx. Say the word and get the bird. Now I want to tell you something else. There's a man here from the Hall of Fame. You want me to put it down here?
Okay.
There's a man here that made basketball history. Gordon Brother Vogel today. This man is now going to be an all-star in the Pharmaceutical College of Basketball. I'm going to pass the baton to him. Brother Mevacor, alias Woke.
I have to tell you something. In high school, he made fun of me. He would hit you with one or two quick one-liners that I thought he was making fun of me with. In college, he hit me with three one-liners, and I knew he was making fun of me. The first day here, he hit me with four one-liners, and the schmuck is still making fun of me. I can't believe him. The only thing I liked about him was Maxine, and she left him. I love you.
He's done.
Now, Sandy Gorlick, I come up here, I pull up here. I'm a little nervous because I'm afraid. I mean, all these guys I know all my life as a kid, and now I'm coming up 35 years later. I haven't seen most of them. I'm getting kind of nervous.
You've been nice and loud your whole life.
You don't remember, Aaron. You forgot.
That was the best line.
I come up and some guy says, "Do you know who I am?" He's 55 pounds heavier, and he has no hair, right? I just saw a video of him when he was 118 pounds running at about an eight-second mile. I mean, a guy, do I recognize him? There are some guys that I really did recognize. You can't, you know, the nose don't grow anymore. It doesn't get any less. You notice Lenny. Lenny's good. And the ponytail whiz. Kaiser, we were never very friendly or close. I always respected you. I never knew why, but I respected you. And I still respect you, but again, I still don't know why. And I did a job on Vogel today. I wouldn't let him score. And get this one. We had to play the handicap. He had to play the handicap. We had his wife playing on our team. She won the winning basket. She had the winning basket. Honest to God. I now give you to Joel Schneider, quote Taylor.
Brother Taylor, wipe the food from your mouth.
Things get a little sloppy around here.
Brother Taylor.
You're on, brother.
You're on.
Artie.
Yes, sir.
The shooter.
Absolutely. The only pure shooter in the fraternity.
The pure shooter.
The only pure bull shooter.
We're not talking about back in the fraternity room. We're talking about on the court. The knees are gone. Can't move. Practices that shot. Does it all the time. Swish.
The famous call. Get the rebound.
That's the best.
No, well, Lenny has to sing still.
Lenny has to sing?
Oh, yes. Yeah. 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 Lenny got to
pass it over.
Pass this over to
Lenny. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you one of the country's up-and-coming young singers. Leonard Kaplan singing. What are you going to sing tonight, Leonard? You're not going to sing? All right, it's too bad, ladies and gentlemen. Len does not feel like singing, but he's going to say a few words to the rest of the public. Here you go, Lenny Kaplan.
Unfortunately, is that where I'm going to speak?
Yeah.
Fortunately or unfortunately, as the case might be, this rabble has no real understanding of the significance of this man. And if the only four-letter words that make any have any relevance is the word golf. The other five.
All right.
No. Oh. No, I'd like to be serious.
Oh, shut up.
No.
No. What are you going to say?
No. I've probably led the sickest life ever. So what I would really like to say, I think it's like really, really been nice that everybody's come here.
Nice.
And I'm glad that I'm alive to see everybody. And, you know.
We don't know if you are.
No.
Here, hold it close.
No, I just think it's a really, really nice thing that happened.
Put it close to your mouth.
Eric, one more thing. Do you still recommend High Kalani?
And, you know, once again, I want to thank everybody for coming here, and here's Joe.
You ain't getting elected for nothing.
No, I was behind the scenes.
Brother Kaiser!
I really don't know what I'm doing here.
No one else does either. Why you're here?
I'm here with the first Boston convention, and I really don't know. I missed the bus.
20 years ago. Where's Roberta?
She's home. Where's Brenda?
She's not home.
Hey, the class of 1959, 60 through 1975 says thank you very much.
You know, you go through life and it's four or five things that are highlights. And the years at Alabama and my honey DeVita and my pledge brothers and my closeness to this man over here, the butcher, who's a schmuck. But this goes down as one of the finest things. And I thank Jerry and I thank Butcher. And then knowing you guys and getting my clock cleaned on the golf course. Alan Copeland, you did nothing. I thank you all. It's been really swell. Thanks, fellas.
I enjoyed helping Jerry put this together, and I hope everybody else enjoyed it. And I'll say that the 2 years of my university was one of the highlights of my life. And that's it.
All right.
Well, I like to say this is the greatest bar mitzvah I've ever been to. In all seriousness, I'm sorry that some of my pledge brothers weren't here tonight, but I'm here with my roommate.
That's it?
We've been friends for 30 years, and it's been great seeing some of the guys that I remember, like Richard and Shelley and Bruce. And I just hope next 30 years we're all here healthy and able to do this again. My name is Richard Schwartz.
Richie, that was really a great speech. I'm really impressed with it. I just want to thank everybody for, you know, coming, even though we were conned into this. They told us everyone was going to be here from our pledge class, but apparently just Richie and I. But it's really nice to meet these old fellows that we only heard their names before. But it's been really great. And thanks, Alan and Jerry, for putting this whole thing together.
First class. There might be another assessment coming. Hold on, here's Big Stu.
I just like to say that it's really a pleasure to be here. 30 years has gone by real, real fast. I really wish that somebody would have taken the initiative earlier, and maybe we would have done this 15 years earlier and really had some more pleasure. And it's really been a really great to be here. I want to thank Jerry Geist and of course, Butcher, putting this thing together, and this is really a thrill to see some of my older brothers that I never even met. And I'm really glad to be here. And Lenny Stoller, it's always a pleasure to see you. And thank you, everybody.
Being the oldest person in the group tonight, and I transcend the whole group here of 30 or so individuals, I feel it a distinct honor, and I would have paid any price for this weekend, as I've stated before. First, I'd like to give a good deal of thanks to the people who made this possible, Alan Morris and Jerry Geist, who've done an outstanding job. And it was a work of love, as we've all enjoyed ourselves for a period of 4 days. I'm usually the most obnoxious, lovely person at a party such as this, which I will get to in future moments of the evening. But tonight, tonight I do wish to thank everyone, and I've kissed most everyone here, and I'm sincerely happy that the love affair has lasted in excess of 39 years. And I would just like to say that my wife said not to drink too much this evening, to be a nice person, which I normally am, and to also say that the University of Alabama has been a joy to me, and of course, AEPi has been an outstanding accomplishment for all of us to have achieved. Thanks for the evening, gentlemen.
This is going to be profound, guys.
First of all, I'd like to thank Bob Cohn for arranging for our next to get the 1966. I have one thing to say to my good friend Jerry Geist, that all votes are subject to recount.
Did everybody understand what he just said?
Yeah.
I didn't understand what he said.
And I also like to thank Alan Morris for a wonderful weekend. I know he had some help, but I won't want to acknowledge it.
Very little.
it's been super. From the time I heard Wally told me on a telephone conversation there was going to be a reunion, I've looked forward to this day. I've been fortunate. I've traveled a lot in my life, and I've been able to stay in touch with a lot of the guys down through the years. But I think in my wildest imagination, I didn't think we could sustain ourselves for 3.5 days without getting a little bored. And I think it's a compliment to what we had in the years we were in school. We were a unique group, and I still feel we're a very unique group. And I've enjoyed every minute of this weekend. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Larry Ampolsky from Omaha, Nebraska. I think my roommate Sandy Gorlick and I probably came the furthest distance for this fiasco, which we all love. We love being here. It's just a fabulous function. I want to thank Alan Morris and Jerry Geist. I know him real well. For going to the trouble of organizing it and really doing a great job. I want to thank Bob Cohn for inviting us to Atlanta in 93. And I want to thank Alan Copeland for taking care of the entertainment for Atlanta with Marla Maples. Marla Maples will be, I did say, Chuck. It's great being here. The nostalgia and the friendship and the brotherhood and the camaraderie is just heartwarming and made it all worthwhile. I'll pass it on to Mike Camp.
Hi, I'm Mike Camp, originally from the north. Like the rest of the guys, this guy here is the one who rushed me, made me come from Michigan State down to Alabama, and the truth is, it was the best move I ever made. I want to just, again, thank Butcher and old Jerry for all the work they did. Fact is that I directed them last year to do it, and they carried out my orders very, very well. Still, as a and I want to thank you all for my retirement that you're paying to this day. My wife Barbara, who there are about 5 or 6 of us who met our wives at the University of Alabama, and there's probably about 3 or 4 that are still with them. So we've done pretty well over the years. Okay. With that, I want to pass it to my big brother from the fraternity and next door neighbor for 11 years in Virginia, Marshall Ginsburg.
Thank you, little brother. I appreciate it. No, it's just been a great week, and closer. I never did this from this side of the camera before, but anyways, it's really wonderful. The 33 years of getting everybody together. We should have gotten together 15 years before. We really waited too long. It's been a fantastic weekend, and I want to thank everybody to put this thing together. I understand this year Miami, 3 years in Atlanta. We're getting closer to Tuscaloosa. You notice Miami. Atlanta and Tuscaloosa 3 years from now. So I hope everybody stays well, and it's been a terrific weekend. Bert, we room together. This is my old roommate. Jeez.
Okay, thank you, Marshall. Pete, hold it down. 1 second.
getting my thoughts together. I want to thank everybody that was involved in putting this together. I think that the selection of the city and being able to get all these guys together is just incredible. It's phenomenal. At any rate, I want to say just a couple of things. I'm originally from Nashville, one of the few token Southerners at the AEPi fraternity group in Alabama, now living in Houston. I want to say that when I first came to Alabama and became a member of the AEPi fraternity, all I know was y'all. When I graduated, I knew nothing but you guys. Excuse me. Just kidding. I think it's been a great experience for anybody to attend not only a great college, a university, but also having such terrific guys as partners in life. And to make it kind of sentimental, I want to wish everybody another happy 33 years, good nachas, and l'chaim.
I'd like to just say something right now. We've all chipped in. Bob Cohn's insurance policy on his health is paid for the next 3 years.
You guys are crazy. Am I on now? About eight months ago, when I received a letter stating that the AEPi Union was going to take place, before I even opened the envelope, I was having hot flashes. This is something that you don't forget. 4 years of college, we had such a mixture of people from the north, from the south, from the east to the west, and the camaraderie never ends. I called my wife the other day. She said, "You sound like a kid again." I think being with everybody here is fantastic, and it shows how a group of people can stay friendly through all the years. Thank you again for Alan and Jerry Geis for all the work, and everybody else.
Cheese. Identify and validate the marvelous weekend experience that this has been. And unfortunately, there are...
Crap! This man is an immigrant!
He is an immigrant!
He came across... He has no knowledge of anything. This man swam across from the border in a red Studebaker with a blown-out carburetor. He knows nothing. He can't speak, this guy.
I give up.
I've got one distinction. I was the first pledge of all this group here because I was a pledge in September of 1951. If anybody can top that, I dare you. But I had a really distinct privilege of, in addition to going to Alabama and being an AEPi from 51 to 55, I worked in radio for a year and a half in Tuscaloosa, so I got to know the group that came a year and a half after me. Then after 2 years of service, I was in broadcasting for 10 or 12 years in Tuscaloosa, so I sort of span all these years and feel like I'm kind of a part of all these pledge groups, and it's really been a lot of fun for me.
Stan. Tell them about some of the basketball games, Stan. Tell them about some of the basketball games.
Gary Thompson, Phillip 66.
I had the distinct privilege of being the Alabama broadcaster when two of the greatest players to ever wear the crimson and white, Lenny Kaplan and Jerry Vogel. Two of the great ones.
Stan, they were Kentucky killers.
Guys.
How much did that cost?
Bob first.
I'm Sandy Grossman, the class of 57. You know what the most amazing thing is? Guys, when you were in college that you thought were assholes back then, haven't changed. And you know, for the first hour, everybody's patting each other back. It's wonderful to see you. And then you realize why you were glad to get rid of them. Now, this is a lot of fun. It's great. There's a lot of people you haven't seen all these years. And it's amazing how everybody has changed. It's all bullshit. You haven't changed a bit. You look the same. Oh, wait a minute. You're not allowed to talk.
Yes, I am. I want to ask you a serious question.
What's that?
There's a guy named Levinson in Baltimore who recreated all of the experiences that he lived through in Baltimore. Are you going to do the same thing for the University of Alabama? Are you going to put together something that will live forever, as Levinson did with his heritage. You know who I'm talking about.
Sign right here. Sign
hey, you know
right
what? Here. All of you who never let him talk, you were justified. 100%. What are you talking about? You know, these are the guys who would like to put you down to posterity as being wonderful, great human beings. What can I say about you?
We're punished.
There's nothing. Hey.
We vote for Leroy Mastowitz. I'm telling you.
Wait a minute.
I think it's time that we vote Sandy
Mastowitz
out.
Yes. It goes to show you. I was treasurer then. You know why? Because it was the best scam.
Yeah, you're right.
I used to take all the dry cleaning over to Bama Cleaners across the street, and I used to get kickbacks for them. I paid my way through college, and it was wonderful. It was great. Hey, this is a lot of fun. It really is. And it's amazing how after all these years, all of you can get together and have such camaraderie when years ago we couldn't stand the sight of each other. And here's to the memory of the one guy that nobody can understand who it was. The guy that on Hell Night ate the goldfish and changed the face of Hell Night forever for everyone. Everybody thinks he was a different person. I've heard a lot of different names. Most guys just closed their eyes, wore the blindfold, but there was one guy that bit the fish in half and all the brothers got sick, and nobody remembers who it was.
Yes.
Who was it?
It was Lenny Kaplan, because I was there when he did it.
Lenny?
Where is he?
Where is he?
Where's Lenny Kaplan? Where's Lenny Kaplan?
Here he is. This is Lenny Kaplan.
What's so?
This is Lenny Kaplan.
I remember hearing about him.
This is Lenny Kaplan right here.
No. No, there was somebody else. Who else said it? Everybody else, who do you think it was?
I saw him do it.
Lenny Kaplan.
I saw the myth froze. I think 60 Minutes might have to do an expose. And now I'd like to pass it on to the guy. So you guys have all missed the boat. You're all looking ahead to 1996. But here's a guy who will invite you to next year's Super Bowl in Atlanta. I would be glad to, but CBS doesn't have the contract. Bob Cohen.
Wait. Guys, this is like Rodney King. Once he says something about Atlanta in 96, we got him by the balls.
Hey, you know what happened to Rodney King, don't you, by the way? The cops thought he was a piñata.
Tell a toe drug.
No. It wasn't LA, right?
I've got another piñata.
Wait a minute. I want you to meet Rodney King. This man was beaten by the LAPD. And he won the biggest case.
Listen, I came down here on a mission, really. These people don't realize that, but I came down here to try to find 35 or 40 guys who are interested in synchronized swimming. The modern pentathlon, and Greco-Roman wrestling. We were trying to figure out what to do with these tickets.
What about team handball?
Team handball.
Archery.
We got it covered.
You're now
filled with places. Oh, yeah. Now, I tell you, on a serious note, though, this has been great, and I don't know, when you meet people and look at people like you see in this room, it's appalling, really. But there are two guys. My memory of this thing really will focus on a couple of guys who have been long lost in my life, really. Chucky Froese and Aaron Shonowitz. It's been a real kick to see these guys. Real kick to see those particular guys, and I can't remember why.
Because I don't get no respect.
No respect. In any event, we got the rooms ready for Atlanta in 96.
Yeah!
We'll see you there.
All right. We got him on tape.
Lenny, this is serious stuff. I think we all want to thank Alan and Jerry for setting the whole thing up. It really, really sensational. When I got this thing in the mail, I knew I was going to come. And then I was coming down on a plane. I said to my wife, you know, I'm sure I'm going to have a lot of fun the first night.
Excuse me. Walk on every table? Isn't that a little bit too much?
Hey, no, I'm being serious stuff now.
A little bit too much?
I'm being serious stuff. I knew I was going to come down on a plane. I was telling my wife, I'm sure I'll have fun the first night.
But after that, it could be a problem. You know, we don't know each other. I haven't seen each other in 35 years. There are guys there I never, ever knew or saw.
I got to tell you, this man, this...
I'm telling you again, in high school, he pain in the ass, and he hasn't changed. Okay, now, when I met everyone the first night here, Bob, I mean, we met guys that I never knew before, guys that were in pledge classes. Guys that were in pledge classes after I left and stuff like that. I mean, I jotted some names down, and I mean, I didn't know Howie and Stewie Green. I didn't know Bruce or Alan. I didn't know Barbara Brasley. I didn't know any of those guys. But I tell you something, honestly, if I was in a house when they were coming in, after what I see here, I would have voted for them also. Very seriously, I think it was terrific. Of the guy,
blackball right now. Who would you blackball?
You're pushing
Jerry Geiser.
No. I'll tell you something else. I said before about running up, people say, did you notice anyone? Like, Mike, I didn't recognize you, but after being for a day or so with you, you got the same little smile, baby face you had then. Honest to goodness, it really is terrific. Pete Leese, do you recognize me? I didn't, but I'll tell you now, after listening to him speak for a few days and seeing his smile, honest to goodness, he looks the same. He really looks the same. Yes, Walter Witherspoon. We had a guy that was really nice to us. When we had parties, because it was a dry county, we were able to give him our liquor, and he could hold it for us so that we wouldn't get in trouble. And you always knew Walter when he held your liquor, because the next morning when he came to eat, and he came to give you stuff, and he'd go like this. He couldn't find the table. The man could not find the table. And now, we go in, all the guys that I did know, and really, a lot of you look different, you change. But after this few days, you really haven't. It really has been a lot of fun, and I want to thank everyone for all of us. I'm sure it has been a terrific few days.
I want to make one toast, and maybe Lenny will remember this. I was a pledge in 51. In 1952, we pledged 35 young men. That was called the Lost Pledge Class, because of 35 pledges, only three became brothers. They were really great scholars. So to the Lost Pledge Class of 52.
Hey, how many guys were recruited on the train?
How about Tepa?
34.
How about Tepa coming?
It goes without saying that this has been a love affair since Thursday. And I can't put any different words or handles on what we've done the last few days.
I fell in love with three of you. I'm not going to tell you which three, but it was a love affair.
Hey, that's like most of your love affairs, 3 days. Oh, my God.
More importantly, we've gotten together and we've found ourselves again after many, many years. I realize that I transcend the whole group, so to speak. And I am the oldest one
here.
Someone
says you're our father.
I'm a grandfather, a mother scuffler, and a little of everything. And I'm 63 years of age.
Yay! Yay!
Who
is 63 and 59?
I know I was always old to all of you. But I've gained a few years, and so have you.
Hey, thank God for you.
Thank you. And I don't have to say you have been expressing yourselves as you've spoken before the cameras. And you've said exactly how you feel and what you've done this weekend and what you've enjoyed. I think it only natural that each of us, one by one, table by table, to just say two things. Number one, your status in life today, you're married, how many children you have, and where you're living. Would you do me that favor? So that each one of us understand where we're coming from, table by table.
Lenny, before we do that, I'd like to say one little thing. There are six brothers here. I mean, there are six brothers who are not here tonight. And unfortunately, we thank God that we are here, and we're fortunate to be here, and we're healthy, and we have wonderful families. But there are six brothers I'd like to announce that are not here. I think everyone here will remember some of them. Ben Siegel, Paul Paper, Alex Etkin, Paul Sobel, Alan Stein, and Noel Dupin. Remember how fortunate we are to be here, guys. Just 30 seconds of just thought about that. Thank you. Larry Katz and Bob Stern were just brought up also. They aren't here tonight, unfortunately.
Herbie Impulsky,
yes. Anybody else? Probably Walter Witherspoon and Mrs. Miller.
Susie.
Okay, let's not make a joke of the obituaries, guys.
What about the...
Okay, really, we are all fortunate. Lenny, what I was going to say is, as each one of you come up, as each one of you come up and speak, I think my microphone's louder than Lenny's. Just say, like he said, and also say something you want to say, whether it's personal or you want to roast somebody, and there's a lot of roasting here, guys, tonight. Okay, so let's start with Bob Cohn's table and work around.
Let me first start with the, after me, the elder statesman of the group, Stanley Siegel.
Yay! Yeah, all right.
I think I've told most of you I've spent a lot of years in Tuscaloosa, but since then I've been in West Virginia and I'm in El Paso, Texas now. I'm in the television business, and it's stations like me that make Grossman a rich man today because we carry all the CBS sports. But I'd just like to say one thing. You know, when I joined AEPi in 1951, we were a very predominantly Eastern fraternity. Almost all the guys came from New York or New Jersey, and I'll be very honest. I had a few agonizing months that did I really make the right choice? Would I have been happier as a Kappa Nu or a ZBT? And I'll tell you this, as the years have gone by, those thoughts have certainly disappeared because over the years I've been able to maintain friendships with people like Sandy and Paul Price and just so many people. And almost everywhere you go in the country, you run into an AEPi here or there. And we look back over the last 30 some odd years, it sure makes me think I made a great choice. Thank you.
Very nice.
Next, I'd like to call Sandy Grossman.
Thank you. I'm living in Boca Raton, Florida now. I moved down here about 6.5 years ago, and I'm still working for CBS full-time, and it's just nice to be able to commute out of here. University of Alabama is kind of funny. I graduated the University of Alabama, and even though I traveled around the country doing all these different sporting events, I had never done a University of Alabama game. And there was one football game against Penn State where the director got sick, and they called me up last minute to come down and direct the game. That's the famous game where the Penn State guy backed up and blocked his own kick or something like that. But anyway, the fun thing about it, I got to go back to the campus, and for the first time got to meet Bear Bryant, and sat on the campus and talked to him for a while, and a week later he was dead. And it was kind of interesting to have a chance, because every time we go to Alabama, they said, oh, you were there with Bear Bryant. And it's awfully tough to say, no, I was there way before him. That's a tough thing. But the good thing is I got a chance to go back there several years ago. They invited me back to be honored for whatever reason. I have no idea, the communication school. And the chance to watch a football game for the president's box. And all I kept thinking about was, when I was there, if I went near the president's box, I probably would have been arrested. We used to take the War Eagle signs and cut them down at Tutwiler Hall, at Tutwiler Hotel or something in Birmingham, and bring them back to the campus, and the police would arrest you and all that kind of stuff. You know, you can't pay for memories, no matter what you do. I mean, I travel around the country, and I've got great memories of my work, and I work with great people. And I can stand here name drop and everything else, because people love you when you do that. But they can't take away your past. And that's something that's very, very precious to all of us. And it's funny, when I heard about this, I was afraid I wasn't going to be here. I wasn't sure if I'd be here. And I looked at some of the names, and none of my class was there. But it really doesn't make any difference, because we all have a common bond. And we all went to school there. We all, for one reason or another, we all found wonderful, wonderful times there, wonderful friends there. And it's just nice to get together with a bunch of people who can sit back and look back at something that we really feel good about. I mean, there's funny ties to all kinds of people. I mean, I grew up, you know, with Larry's family. Herbie Impulsky was a guy I idolized when I was growing up. I loved Natalie Pepper when I was growing up, but she was a little girl, a sweet kid in her family. And I dated, I mean, I started talking about people I dated and talked to a former date of mine, Joyce, tonight. It was kind of fun. So it's just nice that all of us can get together, and it's amazing how your paths, when you start to look at it, have intertwined in some way. And it's just good that it's a nice bunch of people that can look back and have fond memories, because no matter how far you go in life, you can never buy or repurchase the memories you've gotten. And it's fun. I'm glad I came. Thank you, Sandy. Bob Cohn.
Get you in Atlanta, Bob, please.
First of all, I have to apologize for not being properly attired. In my wireless, I didn't read the instructions. In my wireless dreams, I never thought about coming to this heat swamp and wearing a coat and tie. But I do apologize to you for appearing like this. In any event, you know, I really hadn't thought about it until everybody started talking, and you think about your own life and some breaks you got along the way. And I've often thought about the people that have helped me in business over the years, but when you start looking at this group, I don't think that I would have been able to, I don't really think I'd be where I'm at today. When you look back and think about it, without Lenny Stola and AEPi standing behind me, really, when I ran for in a campus election for editor of the Crimson White, that really sort of set me on a path from which I really never diverted. And had Lenny not been in the position that he was at the University of Alabama to support me in that endeavor, really, I think I probably would have gone in a completely different direction. Maybe made a lot more money quicker. but that was a real treat. As I said earlier on the little tape, some of you probably didn't hear it. I don't know why, and really some things strike you as strange, but for some reason, seeing Aaron and Chuck Ephros were, seriously, had a very special meaning to me here. Among the whole crowd, there was something, there was a little electricity in the air for me when I saw the two of them. Brought back some very fond memories, some good times. I very much appreciate being invited. I'm glad that I came, and I look forward to all of you being in Atlanta. And we were talking at our table about the possibility also of another get-together in the year 2000, the change of the millennium at the Wailing Wall, December 31st, 1999.
Bert.
Bert Cohen, Houston, Texas, originally from Nashville, Tennessee. Alan Morris, would you come up, please?
Where's Al Evans?
Are you getting engaged?
Where's Al Evans? Where's Al Evans?
Jason still in Nashville?
Oh, he's in Memphis.
Go get him, Butch.
You guys getting leveled in?
I want to say something here that, you know, it's nice to be able to come to a great event and affair like this with, we'll all remember, but I wanted to present something to these two gentlemen, these two guys that put this whole thing on, that they would remember, they could look at and remember. So, with further ado, I want to present you, Jerry.
Spell my name wrong. I'm just kidding.
I know it's right. And Alan Morris. Come over here.
Oh, spell with an I.
This says certificate. This says certificate of recognition. We hereby present Alan Morris and Jerry Geist with this certificate acknowledging your achievements and contribution towards the immensely successful Alabama AEPi reunion awarded this 22nd day of May, 1993, Iota Deuteron Brothers.
Hey guys, put up this score next to the Alabama Miami score.
Look over here. Good. Okay, good. Thank you.
I think everybody here knows it was the greatest times of our lives, and we just did out of a labor of love, and we're so glad you all came. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Gary and I were really never close in our years of last 30 years or so, and even in school. But I think in the last 3 or 4 months, we've really gotten close, and we've gotten become good friends. And I sold him a computer system that I made.
guys, we have businessmen here. $300,000 for a computer system? Is it fair, guys?
Guys. I want to know why Jerry Geis is the only one here who looks like a grandfather.
Yeah, Polsky, I have the last thing in what is it called? Good and Welfare? You're gone, yeah, Polsky.
I hope so. You know, when I left Nebraska to come down here, everybody said, where are you going? And I said, well, I'm going to Miami for a fraternity convention. There's going to be a lot of male bonding, and sure enough, that's what it is. We bonded a long time ago, and I think we've remained bonded, and we will continue to be bonded. It's a wonderful feeling to be here with everybody. I wish some other people could be here to share this experience. Alan Morris is the sweetest human being walking the face of the earth.
Absolutely.
Without a doubt. And I hope we can get together again soon. I do want to thank not only Stan and Don, but their folks. You know, when people were being rushed for AEPi, it was the Siegel Cabot. You know, we can't wait to get you to come out to the Siegel Cabot. I think they played a big part in all of us who accepted AEPi. What? So on the Broads too, and I want to extend a special thank you to all of the Siegel family.
Absolutely.
They were as big a part of the University of Alabama as AEPi was for all of us, and it's just great to see everybody. And you know the funny thing that I noticed when you're in Alabama and you have freshmen and sophomores and juniors and seniors, no one really clicked real well together. Well, they had their individual clicks, but I notice here age and pledge classes don't really mean anything. We're all together as brothers, and some people who didn't talk to other people years ago are now hugging and kissing, and I think it's great. And thank you for having me here.
Thank you.
Ricky Ricardo.
Mike Camp. Hi, Mike Camp from Indian Harbor Beach, Florida right now, which is about 16 miles south of Cape Canaveral. Moved down here about 3 years ago. Again, I want to thank Alan and my friend Groucho for all the work they did on this. We joked about it, and we talked about it. A group of us has stayed close probably over the last 20 years, seeing each other on and off, and we talked about it for 20 years, and until I directed Alan and Wally, being former military, they carried out the mission real well, and I'm really proud of them. The other thing is that I probably owe my life to all you guys from New York. No, that's true. The New Yorkers are crude, they're aggressive, they're everything in New York has a reputation to be. And that's why I went in the military. I was the only one that was a legal professional killer, and I still am trained well for that, so watch it. We want to thank the comment that was just made about pledge classes by Larry not being together is wrong. Our pledge class will never forget Lenny Kaplan's chocolate milk, Aaron Shaunowitz's, Aaron Shaw, your gentle treatment of pledges. We will never forget that.
Roasting already, guys.
Tonight may be your night. We don't know, but it may be your night. In any case, it was really great seeing everybody. It's been a pleasure. My wife came down. Of course, she came in after a lot of you guys, but she was a sophomore or a freshman when I was a sophomore. And we met and we married, and a whole bunch of us from our pledge class met our wives here, and still with them today and doing pretty
good.
Speak
for yourself, Cam.
I said some of us. Anyway, thanks, everybody, and it's been a pleasure with all of you.
Very nice, very nice.
Marshall.
Go
they got a speech, Marshal.
I don't.
He's going to sell the University of Alabama. You be sure of that.
Everybody knows I love my alma mater, but this fraternity is something else. I probably missed out on a year because I pledged as a sophomore. I stayed out of a year.
You were in the motel with Sue.
Probably something like that. The Bel Air Room 4, Sandy, was that? For those who were able to make it, were able to make it tonight but didn't, I really think it's their loss. They told me 6 inches away when I was in communication.
What are you talking about 6 inches?
You never had 6 inches.
Seriously, I want to thank everybody that came tonight, this weekend, because it really gave me an opportunity to get back together with you. I really want to thank you for giving me that opportunity. Alan, Jerry, just a terrific job. I'll always remember this night, and I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Why should anything change 32 years later?
First of all, this is supposed to be a roast, but I'm not about to roast
anybody. No, we're not roasting now.
I'm not roasting you. You're lucky. You're very fortunate. One thing is I feel very fortunate to be here. Before I came down here, my parents told me that they had a friend here who was a legacy in a ZBT. So I was all prepared to be a Zeeb. And here I'm coming down on a train. I was just 17 years old. I was 6 in June. I was 17 by about 3 months. And here I come down on this train. And all of a sudden, I guess in Gadsden, is that before Birmingham?
Yes.
All of a sudden, here comes a horde of guys on the train. It must have been, and only one guy I remember though was Stan Babbitt. I don't know if you guys remember him. The short guy with glasses.
We should have never allowed him to do it.
Well, that's right. But anyway, he came and got me off the train. Here I am. I don't know where the hell I was. Here I am in Birmingham. I didn't know where Birmingham was. They took me off the train in a car. I don't know who. I think he had his yellow, whatever the hell it was, a yellow car. Right, Gary? Knows. Took us up to the fraternity house. And on the front steps was, I'm all right, was Jerry Bloom. I remember that. Was Howie Fink. They had beer cans in their hand. Anyway, to make a long story short, it was a great experience. And something else with you guys, one thing you guys have not mentioned yet, we're not all New Yorkers, we're not all Southerners, we're not all Easterners. We have such a mix of people here. We have Southerners, we have Northerners, we have New Yorkers who you guys malign. My mother is from New York, so I will not malign you guys. I think it's great. And we had such a camaraderie there, which you didn't realize when you were there. I just had a son who graduated from college, and one thing I told him is that, Greg, when you graduate from college, you're going to realize it's the best experience you've ever been through. And he graduated last year, and it's just unbelievable. Another thing, I met my wife here, Eileen Sternberg. You probably don't remember her.
Well,
she was an AEPi. You should be so lucky. But anyway.
Let's hear from Eileen.
In that quarter last night, I said, Eileen, don't take offense, but I'm having such a great time here. You're not here, but to see everybody here like this is really great. And I really appreciate it. I will not roast you. I can roast like 6 or 7 people here, but I will not do that tonight because I don't think it's for my place to do that. But I thank you all. I appreciate it. Richard.
Who's Richard? Who's Paul? Oh,
too young yet.
He's too young. You got to be the older guys.
We're aging by the minute. By the time you leave here, you're going to be old.
Well, I was in high school when all you guys were graduating, so that's why you don't know me. I'm Richard Allardyce. I live in Miami Beach. And I did know some of you who are here, and it was really great to see all of you. It was a tremendous experience for me. I was born and grew up in Montgomery, Alabama. And to join a fraternity full of people from, you know, New York was really something special. I was sort of run out of the family because everybody else was a Kappa Nu. But I will reiterate what has been said by so many people. The diversity of culture and background of all of you made my experience in college something special. And it gave me an opportunity to vicariously experience life around the country. Having grown up in a city in Alabama, which was not very large then, it was very limiting. And AEPi was something special, and it was different. It was full of a bunch of assholes, and fortunately, we're still here. but then I became one of you, and then what else could I be? So it's been really good to be here and see some people that I haven't seen for a long time. And it's funny, I think y'all look the same now. Of course, I do too. I was gray-haired when I got to school, and I haven't changed a bit. But it's been great to be back here and see you, and I hope to see you again in the future. Atlanta in 96, Jerusalem in 2000, and wherever else we may end up. Thank you very much.
Very nice.
Hi, I'm Don Siegel from Birmingham, Alabama, via Tuscaloosa, Alabama. You know, AEPi is just sort of a part of the family. I guess growing up, I remember the AEPi days from before the AEPi house, back when it was the old house next to Art's Char House. And my daddy's involvement, my Uncle Harry's involvement, my older brothers, Ben, Stanley, and Alan, you know, I mean, it was just a part. There was no question, was Don Siegel going to be an AEPi? I mean, AEPi was in my blood. And I'll tell you, you know, over the years, I've loved every one of you. You know, and I've stayed in touch with so many of you. And those I hadn't stayed in touch with have meant so much to me. I'm married to Bobby Solomon, who was an AEPi at Alabama. We have two children, a son, Brian, who is a sophomore at the University of Texas, and a daughter, Rochelle, who is a junior at the University of Georgia. It's just been a wonderful experience this weekend seeing you. A lot of you I didn't know that well because you were friends of my older brothers. Some of you I've known very well, stayed so friendly with. I mean, gosh, the memories that I have from Wally Kaner and Alan Morris and Jerry Geist and just the old days at the university will always mean something to me. But AEPi is just a part of my life. This has been a wonderful weekend. I just wish all of you a lot of health and happiness, and can't tell you how much it has been a pleasure to be with you. Thank you.
Bob Abrasion.
Hi, my name's Bob Abrasely. I'm in Houston, Texas now. And the things that I remember most was Hell Week. And Alan Morris, when he was trying to eat the fish. He was stepping on it. No, but I mean, it's really, really great. I mean, these last 3 days just have telescoped the time into nothing. And we love you, Jerry, even if you are a schmuck.
Yeah. I see a few people.
Can I say something? Why did that thing get the biggest applause of all?
Howie.
Bob, why'd you tell us how you really
feel? He's harbored that for all these years.
Don't hold back.
The old man.
Howard Levine, Miami, Florida. I remember when it was easy to get up on a platform like this. All year long, I've watched Jerry pursue everybody around that's here and other people who aren't here, and I want you to know he put in a lot of time and a lot of effort, and I want to recognize him for that. I didn't see what Alan went through. I'm sure it was the same.
More.
Yeah, communicate with me.
Anyhow, I have to admit that since coming to Miami, I've become a Hurricane fan. And I really wanted, after that game, very much to get a saliva test on that guy, T. I've never seen a guy come from 10 yards behind a guy who runs a 4.5 40, catch a man down, and go the other way, and not be on some kind of performance-enhancing something.
Is that illegal?
Every time I go into Jerry's store, I have to see the score. But anyhow, I'm having a terrific time. It's really great to see all you guys. I remember a little more hair in general, but you're all looking good and sounding good, and I feel fortunate to be here and share it with you. Thank you.
Very nice.
Alan Copeland.
Guys, if you need interpretation, I'll be glad to help you on this one.
This is tough, guys. This is tough.
You know, Alan Marks may be the sweetest guy in the world, but this guy's been the biggest pain in the ass of most of us here in sometime in our life. I love him anyway. I'm from Birmingham, Alabama, and I drill for dollars there. I'm originally from Dalton, Georgia, and Dalton holds a few distinctions, like Marla Maples and the only AEPi that ever went to Alabama. AEPi was in my blood too. It was my brother. He blazed some trails. He got kicked out of the Emory chapter for balling some girl in the house mother's bed. But AEPi was in my blood. It's true. But anyway, all my friends. I have to say the same things. The diversity of the chapter at Alabama really makes it distinctive, I think. We were just talking 6 or 7 years ago. We have a semi-reunion in New York. Well, hell, if it wasn't for AEPi in Alabama, we couldn't have a reunion in New York for the Alabama-Ohio State kickoff classic. I used to have a lot of ties to Miami. I used to keep up with some of the guys down here. I no longer have those ties. But this has been terrific. So all I can say, I've met new friends, my tennis buddies, it's been great. So, glad to be here.
Bruce Melman.
Bruce. Jerry wants to know what happened to his shrimp.
He's an animal. I'd like to first identify one of our unofficial social chairmen of our chapter, which was Jean the Machine. She couldn't make it tonight. In a retirement home somewhere.
That's because she made it so many times before.
I always used to, when she used to come to a football game, everybody was sort of hiding their head looking the other way. But this has been just super. Coming here and seeing everybody, seeing the people that I'd heard about over the years and never met, and it's been terrific. I see that fellas like Chuck is tremendous. Should be an MC somewhere. I don't know where, but somewhere. And far away.
You see, after you, Bruce, you gotta be quiet. I'm telling you.
But I want to thank Jerry and Alan for doing such a tremendous job getting us all together, and the generous offer that Bob Cohen has made for hosting us. So thanks very much, and I'm glad I'm here to see everybody.
And Shelley Stapleton.
His nickname was Gramps. You'll know after this speech.
You may fall asleep talking. I want to thank Alan Morrison. What's your name? Geist?
Geist.
It's nice to see guys after 20 years, 25 years, 3 inches shorter and 25 pounds heavier. I had a great time this weekend. I enjoyed myself, and there are guys I haven't seen here that I'm sure in the future I will become a lot closer to. Thank you.
Oh boy, look at that.
Oh. Jerry, did we really take a vote?
Guys, you can cover years on this one.
Don't listen to him, Gary.
Go for it, little guy.
Get him by the
first
throat.
Of all, I'd like to say Jerry drove me nuts when I was at school and he hasn't stopped for 3 days. The fraternity meant an awful lot to me. I felt for many years, because I grew up without a father. I came to the University of Alabama 17 years old. And a lot of you people weren't my fathers, but you became my good friends. And I had a period of my life that was not great. And I really found out what the fraternity was about because 25 years ago, there's two guys in this room that were right there for me, and that was Wally and Bruce Millman. And yes, Jerry, I have been in a lot of offices. And I felt you guys have been my friends, always will be my friends, and there's been something unique that I've realized about our time at the University of Alabama. And I can't put my finger on it, but it's a real uniqueness. And we were some kind of different group, unique, but we really were a close group of guys, and I've enjoyed this last 3 days.
I think the word he's thinking of is love, guys. I really do. We all love each other.
Wally Kaner.
Oh, boy. Try and sell a sneaker, you're in trouble.
Be nice to Wally. He's a nice guy, Jerry.
Free sneakers, Wally.
For everyone in the room, sure. This has been a very easy act to follow. the farmer's daughter sends her regards to everyone. You know,
that's fancy.
My son was an AEPi at the University of Hartford, and I encouraged my daughter, and Yam's daughter was also an AEPi at the University of Arizona, and we encouraged our kids to go fraternity and sorority because of what we felt for most of you guys. I can go table by table and pick out guys here, 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 and here, and just relate stories forever. It was wonderful. The way I covered Gary Thompson from Iowa State and the Phillips 66 Oilers. Oh, excuse me, that was you, Lenny. It was one of us. And it was just great. And I owe a lot of indebtedness to you all. Times change from when I had enough hair to have a crew cut to seeing Aaron with his ponytail. Times change, but a lot of things stay the same. And after spending an hour or two, the same mannerisms in Mishigasa with us all. And it's just been real swell, fellas, and thank you all. You've been a big part of my life.
Alan.
I want to thank Alan Morris for doing such a great job with this. I'm Alan Morris, and I'm from Gadsden, Alabama. I'm like Alan Copeland, the only AEPi from Gadsden, Alabama. As a matter of fact, the only Jew from Gadsden, Alabama.
But we're not so sure about that.
That's right. Y'all, Gary's a Jew. And although I spent only 2 years at the university, there are 2 years of my life that I will never forget. I spent 4 years at Auburn at pharmacy school. I have four children, two daughters who now attend Auburn University, and two stepsons who attend college in Colorado. And I want to say that I really enjoyed putting this reunion together with Jerry. And I'm looking forward to 1996. And Bob, anything that I can do to help, I'd be happy to do.
Richard Schwartz.
How are you?
Hey, no smoking out there.
Guys, if you have any question about if he dyes his hair, that's between me and Richard.
I want to say thank you to Jerry for having me. I was one of the last pledge classes to be at the University of Alabama, unfortunately, so I didn't really get to know a lot of you. I remember looking at your pictures on the wall in the dining room, and I'm finally glad I got an opportunity to meet most of you. And it was great seeing some of the guys that I spent a year with, Shelley and Dave and Wally. And, I especially want to thank Stu Green, who pledged me and took me away from ZBT. And through Stu, I met his brother, Howard, who became my roommate. And Howie and I have been friends for 31 years. And I know Howie's wife, and we had great times. And I'm just very happy to be here, and thanks for having me.
Howie Green.
I'm Howard Green from Binghamton, New York. I have four children, and I'm married to Lynn Schwartz, DFIE, for 27 years. I never majored in public speaking, so I'm going to make it short and sweet. I really appreciate, I didn't know most of you guys at all, but just in this short period of time, I felt like I know you guys forever. And it's a pleasure just even, you know, being a part of this whole group. And I'd like to join you guys back in 96 in Atlanta. And
and Howie's brother, Stuart Green.
Guys, is there pressure on Bob Cohen? Is there pressure on Bob Cohen?
No problem. There's pressure on you, Jim.
We have an expression in Miami, no problem. He keeps on saying that. I'm worried about it, guys.
I'm Stuart Green. Used to be Stewie Green. And I just want to let you know, Bob, that I will be there with my brother to carry his bags. I wasn't as fortunate as most of my older brothers, which I've just met this weekend. I'm really thrilled to have been able to do that. But I wasn't as fortunate to get beat up on a train. A guy named Larry Impulski and a guy named Howie Becker attacked my home in New Jersey. And I never made it to the train. So I never felt the beauty of being rushed off a train, and they conned my mother and father to become a member of AEPi in Alabama. And I was I had a very young face, and it was the first time out of New Jersey. And when I got to Alabama, I got off this three-wheeled plane, Southern Airlines in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. And all these guys from Sammy and ZBT, they were picking up guys, and I was left there to take a cab.
There you go, Larry.
You already played.
Yeah, there was no Yampo, there was no Becker, there was nobody.
We were hustling other guys.
You guys were in good job.
Sit down.
All right, I'm done.
He's
finding
another
call.
I
failed him. They're rough. They're going to be up for an hour anyway. Being this young face, I really had a tough time getting a lot of girls. They always wanted to mother me. But I always used to get into the BAM and the Druid Theater for half price, as a 12-year-old kid. But in all sincerity, it's been really a thrill to be here. And like I said, somebody said before that a lot of the guys that we had always heard about, and you know, it's really great that we were able to meet some of the guys, and it truly was a great experience being at Bama and being at AEPi, and we hope to see everybody in Atlanta with good health. Thank you.
Lenny, I want to start with you at that table since you haven't had an opportunity to speak anywhere in the room before.
Get it all out. It feels as though it's a table that's been blessed. I'm not sure. For 4 years at the university, I spent the first 2 years trying to interpret what the Southerners were saying, and the last 2 years trying to interpret what the New Yorkers were saying, even though I'm from New York, and frankly, I'm still not sure I understand any of them. But it was, it's been a blessing trying to interpret it. This has been a special weekend for me, even though it's been somewhat traumatic, not being at home, taking care of my business. And I'm very thankful that that they found me and they invited me, and I was able to hear some of the wonderful thoughts that you all have been expressing. And if you say one fucking word, Bobo. Thanks, guys. And by the way, Sandy Grossman, I am not on an NBA team. I did not play in an All-American capacity, but I did play for the University of Alabama. I'm shocked you don't remember me. Thanks, guys.
Sandy Garland.
I'm the one guy from Pennsylvania that went to Alabama and now lives in California. But I owe AEPi Alabama a lot. It's through Brother Yampolsky, who introduced me to my wife that I've had a happy 33 years with. I'm sorry, Sandy. But
I apologize, she doesn't feel the same.
I knew when I came back here that I would see a lot of guys, hopefully, that gained 20 or 30 pounds like I had or more. But I know one thing. I want to be generous. But one thing for sure, I knew Shonowitz and I couldn't afford to be 3 inches shorter. But I'm thankful to be your fraternity brother, and I'm glad to see you all again, and I hope we'll all get together in 96 again. Thank you.
Artie Wax. You're the one. You're the goddamn one. Well, I'm Artie Wax from New York. Father, I want to thank you for the invitation for the up-and-coming Olympics. I think it'll be terrific. I'm sure I'll see all of you there.
Opening ceremonies, Artie.
I think it's an opportunity none of us should miss, especially since he's been as gracious as he has been. Going to put the bill for this, and I think it's just anyway, on a serious note, it's been a pleasure. The best thing about it is that I've met people here that over the years I've thought about, but never really been able to see, really didn't know what happened to them. And I think that if anything comes of this, it's my being able to contact some people that I've always wanted to and never have. A lot of people have said a lot of things here, and I think I don't want to reiterate what they've said because it becomes redundant. A couple of things I want to say is I don't think that Alan and Jerry really did that good a job. And the only other thing is that I was a little upset, and I'm not quite sure to this day why we let Southerners in the fraternity. But in any case, guys. Everybody knows I'm kidding. It was a terrific thing. We try to get a balance of people. We always wanted Southerners, Northerners, everybody. It's been a terrific weekend. And Sandy, I'd like you to call my house because somehow or other, maybe if I could get rid of Joyce and maybe, who knows.
She's a sweet
all right.
Girl.
Thanks, guys. It's been a pleasure.
Shut up, Rose.
This should be...
Guys, pay attention. This should be epic.
Not EPROS.
Oh, God.
Anyone who wants to leave?
We just ran out of tape.
Hillary.
You know, a bunch of schmucks.
Who are you?
Yeah, who said that? I came down here expecting to see Jerry Geist, and I found Groucho Marx waiting for me. But
you all expect me to be very cynical. I know I can say some cynical things, but I really had a number of wonderful years at Sammy House. And I want to know why, you know, we talk about Howie Fink, who's in jail, and Dutch Schultz, who's got colitis. Our ex-house mother who has hemorrhoids. I want to know about Vera from Howard Johnson's. I want to know about Diane Brodigan. I want to know about Inez, for some of you old-timers. I know the Seagulls are laughing at that one. Actually, Inez is my first experience on Route 11. With a blanket. But it's been a lot of fun being here.
I didn't know Inez.
You're full of shit.
Everybody knew Inez.
You got it, Seagulls. But it's been a great week for me, and I really enjoyed it. And I quite agree with Artie Wax that Alan and Jerry guys did a shitty job. And I'll be here in 90, when are the Olympics, Bob?
96.
We'll be here.
All right.
Super Bowl is next year.
If you're here, you're going to miss
it.
You
better be in Atlanta.
It's really been a wonderful weekend. It's been a great surprise for me. I've enjoyed it immensely. Emotionally, it's been terrific. You guys really did a great job. Sincerely. And it's great to see you all again. Thank you.
Joel Kaiser.
I don't know about anybody else, but the first 3 months at Alabama, I wanted to get the fuck out of here. I mean, it was terrible. I mean, I couldn't understand anybody. That's why I became an AEPi. Then I met Leonard Stola and Roberta Sugarman. That I was sucked in forever.
Literally.
I have a lot of friends that I've stayed friendly with while I've been in school and since then, and I've made a lot of new friends this weekend, and I really have a great time, and thank you very much.
The Beast, Jerry Vogel. The known ball player.
Set in your style for America. Catch the kneecaps! Get the kneecaps!
Steps are over. Jerry, the steps are over there.
What's the line on? Can't afford socks.
Can't afford socks.
I didn't have any of my dirty laundry.
That's very too long.
Bob, I don't want to go to Olympics. I want to play.
We got a spot for you, too.
Next, I want to know who the hell stole my pants. You know, I want to make one correction. When I came down, the first thing Jerry Guy says was, you know, I really didn't know you, Jerry, but you were at campus. You'd come to the fraternity house from time to time, but you really, I didn't get to know you any, but all the brother would say, watch out for the Beast. He's coming back from the Cocoa House. He's drunk and all. And I feared you for years, but I want to make that correction. It was just an assumption, and I think it played on for years. Everyone would say, watch out for Brother Beast, he's going to get drunk and so forth. But it's been a great 3 days. I think that I met a lot of people who I didn't recognize, and over the course of the last few days, all of a sudden, seeing Brother Yampolsky's pictures and all, reminded me of some of the ways, the way Bob Cohen looked many years ago, and some of the other things. It's just been great the 3 days. I thank you, and I look forward to the next reunion.
Aaron Shonowitz?
Shaw.
He anglicized it, excuse me.
He lost his wits. Did you notice that trot up to the front, guys?
No. Sanity has nothing to do with religion. Everybody's a good person, and everybody that's here is a good person. So, you know, you can just call me Aaron and, you know, consider that I'm all religion, so, okay? So, you know, what I'd like to say is, like, I've been like a Rick Van Winkle, and I went to sleep for like 30 years, and I was really awake, so you all look the same to me. Everybody is 20 years old. You know, I don't know if anybody's really familiar with my life, but I'm getting sort of familiar with my life. And, you know, I'd like to say that the 3 days has brought a lot of stability into my life. I haven't had children. I've been a child for 55 years, and I probably will be a child for a long time. And I'd really like to say, for me, this is very, very special. I think everybody here is beautiful, and it's been a wonderful thing for me. And, like, you've all had families and everything, and, you know, I have a beautiful wife and a really nice, you know, life. I've had a nice life. It's been different than all of you people. But I would really like to say, and I'm looking at you all, and, you know, you're all looking at me, and you're beautiful people. And like I said, I for me, this has been really, really special. I'd like to thank Jerry and Lenny and Lenny Kaplan and Joel Kaiser and everybody in my life. And, you know, my voice is wavering, and all I can tell you is, like, I love everybody here, and I hope you all feel the same way. And, you know, the marriage is just starting. Take care. All right.
Guys, we're cutting Walt's statements to 28 minutes. Look, don't make fun. I have to show this to my family. No, very seriously, I'm Gary Wilkes, Sandy Grossman. They know me as well as they know you. No, I'm only kidding. I want to tell you how I came down to Alabama. We were sitting, six of us were sitting in a lunchroom, and we said, what school can we all get into? And the only one was Alabama. Honest to goodness, the only one was Alabama. And then we might get on a train to Grand Central Station, because we were all rich kids, and we really could afford the planes and all our cars. So we all got on the train in Grand Central Station, and there we met some other rich kids who couldn't get anywhere else, Artie Wax, Lizzie Leibow, and all of us came down on the train together and got rushed into AEPi. And we came down, and it was terrific until we got out of the train. We smelled the paper mill. And we said, oh my God, what are we doing here? And from then on in, it was really a lot of fun from then on in, and we had a great time. And you mentioned all the people Chuck mentioned, and I want to tell you, it was Gene the Machine Marlowe. Was that who it was? Because there was a big fight between Kaiser and Ephros. They both were with her one weekend. They both wanted to marry her, and they didn't know who would marry her. And I guess no one did, and she's still around. She's in a nursing home next to where we'll be. But I really would just like to say in closing, really, that Jerry's shorts belong to his son, his two-year-old son, and he looks good in it. And Bob, I want to thank you, because we all are going. Honestly, goodness.
No problem.
I think if they can light the torch, a good way to light the torch is to have all of us stand on top of this ladder, and we just pass the torch up, and we go AEPi, and we light the torch. You do have that kind of power, right?
No question.
Okay.
No problem.
And the last thing I'd like to say, and I'm saying this to my wife, for years and years, all I ever tell her is the best 4 years, Barney, the best 4 years I've ever had in my life have been at the University of Alabama. And after about 25 years, I'm married, going to be 29 years in June. I have two children, two lovely daughters, both AEPis, one at Florida, one at Wisconsin. One is going into law school down here, and I'm putting a lot of pressure on someone to interview her. But I want to say to my darling wife that the truth is that any 4 years with you were my best and are my best years. That's it.
I don't want to add anything to what all of you have said this evening. And I just want to say thank you for offering me this opportunity to be your MC for the evening. And I'll turn the podium over to Jerry Geis.
Gotta tell the truth, guys. You thought he'd be drunk out of his mind, he'd be a goddamn riot, right? Big disappointment, right, guys? Big disappointment. I just have to say a few things that come to my mind and my heart.
Did Bert Korn get up there?
Yeah, I suppose.
Nicholas, please, Nicholas. I'll be in your room at 2 o'clock. Nicholas, I'll be in your room at 2 o'clock tonight to remind you about Bert Korn's speech. Okay. I just want to say that because of this, like Alan said before, we've become good friends. And he's a gentleman. You guys don't know what a good man he is. And really, I think you all ought to stand up and give him an applause, because without him, we couldn't have done it, guys. Now, I'd like to say a few other things. Now, so many things come to mind about each one of you. Gary Rosen, after this, tomorrow morning, is giving a seminar in public speaking. Okay? Now, another thing is, I'd like to mention each one, my memories of each one of you, just in a second, if you don't mind. Stan Siegel, always coming into the house and being nice and being a gentleman. His family, we went down to the auto parts store, you know, just things that come to my mind.
It's called a chop shop.
Okay. a chop shop, right. They've been stealing cars for many years. Bob Cohn living on the pledge porch. Why was he on the pledge porch? Because I don't know. He was a senior. He's there 8 years. Air Force captain, whatever he was, right? Larry M. Polsky, almost blocking for most people, but a good man, right? Mike Camp taking a shower, guys. Taking a shower. Remember that. Marshall Ginsburg, just a sweet, nice man. Just a real nice man. Bert Cohn running to first base after hitting a hip single to left field. Pete Lee's going. Sandy, I don't know you, Sandy, but you were very funny, and I'm sure everybody here loves you, and we do love you, because, you know, we're all brothers, really, because I feel this way. I was a little skinny kid from the Bronx. I went to Alabama because it was the cheapest school there was in the United States. I spent 37 hours through that Barron's book looking for the cheapest school, and that was the cheapest school, right? Lenny Stoller, when he used to wear his khaki pants and his white shirt, dancing drunk as hell and screaming, ah! You know, Lenny, right? Gary Rosen, almost jumping on a rebound. Never left the ground, guys. Never left the ground. And you know what? He was the center for 3 years. How bad were we, right? Wally Kaner, bunting in softball games every single time. Bunting. I mean, you know, swing the bat, Wally. Alan, I've already spoken about. Richard, you got a good hairstylist, guy. Howie, sweet kid. I hardly knew him, but he's Stewie's brother, the greatest. Stewie Green in the softball championship games, this is the truth, is about 300 people on one side, 300 people on the other side. Stewie's pitching for us. I'm at shortstop. He had a big rear end, right? His pants tore down the middle. He was ready to walk off. Two outs left in the game. I walk out. What did I say to you, Stewie?
He doesn't remember the incident.
I said, Stewie, if you walk off this field, I'm going to castrate you. That's simple as that. He pitched the last two guys. We won the softball championship.
About the home run.
Yeah, Polsky's home run in the dark against Capitano. In the dark, literally, with the bases loaded. Sorry, Yam. Can't remember everything. I can't. Who's behind Sandy?
Someone saw it.
Artie.
What a sweet jump shot, guys. What a sweet jump shot, right? Let me just tell you something. He spoke to one pledge in the whole year he was there. He said, you know what he said? Pass the juice. Sandy Gorelick, I'm telling you, this is from experience. We got in this little black Ford, we headed toward New York. I had to have a tube to piss out the door because he'd never stop. Never would stop. We had to get there, break the all-time record. Lenny Kaplan, two things. In that great game against, I think it was Phillips 66, when he hit about 20 points and we won, and all the pledges were so proud of him, right? And we were sitting in the upper deck, right, Wally? And every time he walked in the fraternity house, I never saw so much money in my life in his pocket, guys. Never saw so much money. Gary Walk playing on the basketball team, and one other thing. Gary Walk was a good basketball player. He blocked out the entire opposing team with his elbows, with his knees. He didn't care how. And Gary Walk fighting every day. It was like he raised the flag in the army. Him and Aaron Schoenowitz. Every time I looked out the window, they were fighting in the front lawn. Aaron, I want to tell you something. This is all seriousness. I've never seen a man that changed so much. And, I didn't know you then because you were a son of a bitch. We hated you, Aaron. We hated you. I mean, hate. You know what hate means, Aaron? Hate. Okay. And what a wonderful man you are today. And God bless you. And I mean that. I saw tears in your eyes and I felt the same thing. I think everybody else here. It was from your heart, Aaron, and that's what counts. Right? Jerry Vogel, the Beast. He said it. For 3 months, all I heard was Vogel was coming to Hell Week. You know what I mean? My knees were banging against it, right? Scared the shit out of me. He came, he just smiled a few times, mumbled something, I don't know what he said, and left. Joel Kaiser, coming in my drugstore with Larry King at 3 o'clock in the morning. Where's the paragarch? Where's the paragarch? I need the paragarch. It's a true story, guys, but you know what? No problem. Okay, Joel, I don't know you, but this weekend I've learned you're a gentleman, you're a wonderful man, and a very good athlete for a man your age. Terrific guy. Okay. Chuck, what do I remember about you, Chuck? Okay. Chuck was a nervous Colombian then, right? Right? But he's a funny guy, guys. He's a funny guy. Remember his dog that would run in the front door, slide through, hit the plate, hit all every wall, bounce off, and Chuck said, it's okay, guys. Okay. Richard, sweet man, Richard. And he's done very well, guys. Done very well. If you need, Walt, listen, don't worry about it. I know him. Your daughter got a job. Don't worry about it. I got a few things on him. We once had a party at his wife's house on Miami Beach. Remember before an Alabama game? We destroyed the fucking place, guys. We destroyed it. Donnie, a sweet man, a great man. Really, part of the Seagulls. What can you say? They're all good people. They're all good people. Bob, we love you, Bob. My pledge brother, stayed the same over 32 years. Hasn't changed one thing. His accent hasn't changed either, guys. Howie, my lovely friend, Howie Levine. The only thing that changed on him was... Do you remember, guys, his name was The Hook? Now, tell the truth. Does anybody remember really what he looked like then? What a handsome guy. Nicholas, put your hands down. Now, Nick...
Podcasting a shadow.
Now, some of you guys want to know why I call him Nicholas. Okay, use your imagination. Nicholas is the funniest guy here. He doesn't mean to be funny, he's funny. I sit in his room at 2 o'clock at night, he says a few things, and I'm in hysterics. Brucey boy, thank God he's here. He almost was killed in an accident many years ago, and he's a sweet man, and Brucey laughs at everything. Doesn't matter what it is. And there's my old roommate, Saberson. Saberson used to say to us, laying on his back, wake me up in 10 seconds. You know what, guys? He was snoring in 4. He was snoring in 4 seconds. We woke him up 6 seconds later, and he popped right up. The greatest man in the world. And just one other thing I want to say. When we all first came here, we really didn't recognize a lot of us. I was Jeff London, Seymour Moskowitz. I introduced myself to 8 guys. Hi, Seymour. Hi, Jeff. Lanny Eisenberg, my old roommate, used to sniff my socks, right? Right? But you know what? If you think about it, guys, we're here an hour or two, and we all look the same. Like we did 32 years ago, and it's like a half a lifetime. And it's just one of the greatest experiences of my life, just being back with you guys again, enjoying these good times, the camaraderie, and like we sit around the room late at night, because I make sure everybody's sleeping. I go to each room, make sure they're all awake, because I can't go to sleep because everybody's... And it was like 32 years ago, guys, 34 years ago, whatever it is. And it's been really great, and I love you all, and hopefully we'll be together again. And hopefully all our families and all of us stay healthy, wealthy, and wise. And thanks so much for the opportunity of me, Alan, and I bringing this to you. Thank you so much.
Above, born beneath old NYU, to thee we give.